Thank you. Symmetry and group theory. The term symmetry is a very qualitative term. It signifies the beauty of the geometrical objects. And to quantitize it, we do have symmetry operations along with symmetry elements. Group theory is a separate part of mathematics, which deals with certain properties of set in abstract algebra. And when a set, particularly the set of symmetry elements here, fulfills certain criterion, then it is given a status of group. Now, this all mathematical formulation has a great significance in dealing properties, predicting vibrational spectra and hybridization, useful in quantum mechanics, simplifying in the Hucker's calculations, optical activity, etc. So we can say that symmetry is a component in chemistry, of course theoretical component, which helps in predicting large number of the chemical. Now, symmetry element is a geometrical entity such as an axis and a plane and a center or a point through which an operation can be performed. So basically, though symmetry elements and symmetry operations go hand in hand, we believe that a symmetry element is simply a geometrical entity like a point, plane, or an axis through which an arbitrary movement is performed. A symmetry operation is of course an arbitrary movement of the body, but the resulting configuration, the resulting operation should yield a superimposable configuration. That means anything that we do is not a symmetry operation. Something that produces a superimposable configuration through a point, plane, or a point would be termed as a symmetry operation. And in general, we have identified 5 symmetry operations. Some people say 4. Identity is sometimes not considered to be an operation. The first thing that is symbolized by capital E, that is identity, it simply says that operation of doing nothing. Well, there is another operation that is called the proper rotation, symbolized by CN, along with an n-fold axis. This is simply rotation by a certain angle, theta. This is 2 pi by theta, 2 pi by n. Like if you are rotating by 120 degree, n would be 360 upon 3, that is 360 upon 120 degree, that would be 3. So it would be a C3 axis. Similarly, if you are rotating by 90 degree, it would be a C4 axis, and so on and so forth. If you are bisecting through a plane, then we term it as a reflection plane or plane of reflection, symbolized by sigma. And if we are inverting all the atoms through a center, then it's called an inversion, or center of inversion, or point of inversion. And if it yields an equivalent or identical configuration or a superimposable configuration, then we understand that this operation is there. The fifth operation, generally called as improper rotation, is not a unique operation in itself. It is actually a combination of 2 independent symmetry operations, that is rotation and reflection. If we are doing rotation first followed by reflection, or doing reflection first followed by rotation, and if it is superimposable configuration, then we understand that such kind of improper rotation is there in the molecule. And of course, the important condition is that the plane must be perpendicular to the rotational axis. Now let us deal them separately, as we have been talking about identity. All molecules do have identity, at least one operation is there that is possessed by all molecules. This operation leaves the entire molecule unchanged. That means we are doing nothing. It's a technical thing. A highly asymmetric molecule such as tetrahedral carbon with 4 different groups attached has only identity and no other symmetry elements. So at least all the molecules contain identity, and this is there for some mathematical reasons, and group theory later on will be able to realize. If we are rotating the molecule through a certain angle so that we have a superimposable configuration, just take the case of water molecule. If you are rotating by 180 degree, just look at this situation. The 2 atoms have been interchanged, though the 2 atoms are indistinguishable, but we understand that they are not identical. But if you are rotating further by 180 degree, we are getting exactly the same thing. That means we are getting identity. So rotation by 180 degree is a symmetry operation, and the axis through which we are rotating is a C2 axis. And since we have rotated 1, we are C2-1, and if we rotate it twice, it will be C2-2, but we understand that C2-2 is only identity.